Danielle Perry for Kerrang Radio here again, filming for Birmingham City University, and today we're at Biad at Gloucester Green campus. And if you can see behind me, this is just one example of some of the things they study here for the course BA Honours in Textile Design. We're going to go have a chat with some students, see what it's all about. So I'm joined by Rebecca and Sue now. I'm in the digital printing room for the textile degree at Biad. So we're going to look at a big piece they're about to start printing here, so let's explain how it's all done.
Okay, we've set the machine up. We need to press remote and you need to press print. Okay, and the information will pass across to the machine.
And this is a PC design, isn't it, Rebecca?
Yeah, it was originally from balloons that I took a photo of and put some chiffon across over it. Literally just cut round it and repeated it. Wow. Then it got like a spine effect down the middle.
I was going to say, it kind of looks like, it reminds me of like a moth or a spine or a
butterfly. It was accidental, and I did it, I was like, yes.
Yes, this worked. It looks brilliant. And it's also been printed onto a chair, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Because that was an awardy one, wasn't it?
Yeah. It was for the...
So what happened? What are you specialising at the moment?
Printed textiles at the moment.
Why do you choose that one?
I like to draw quite a lot, and it's once you've got a drawing, you can easily get that onto fabric. Whereas like CT, you have to like change it all, just put it on the machine and weave in it. So yeah, exactly. And it's fun as well.
So why did you decide to do textiles before? Did you do art for A level?
Yeah, I did GCSE textiles, and I did A level photography, art and textiles. And I wanted to come to the foundation degree. Mm-hmm. And then I was just like, I'm just going to do a degree in it now.
Yeah.
It's been fun. I've enjoyed it.
Nice. And why did you choose BCU?
I looked at a few different unis, and when I came here, I just got the feeling that I wanted to be here. Like, I liked everything that they offered, and I liked the city as well.
So. Yeah. So you know, don't you, when you walk in?
I want to go here. She's like, okay, let's do it.
So we're still here in the digital print room with Rebecca, and it's printing out the piece that you saw us start earlier on. I think it's about 60% of the way through, isn't it? But you can see it all just absolutely building. It's this beautiful piece. And this is the piece that you won that award for, which is made into the chair, which you're going to see in a minute.
Yeah.
And what did that feel like when you saw it? Were you just like, whoa?
I went with my mum, actually, and I hadn't seen it on the chair until we went to the show.
Yeah.
She was like, you did that? I was like, yeah. I was proud of myself. She was like, oh my God. Because obviously she didn't know what I was doing either. I don't really show my work, but when she saw it, she was like, oh, I'm really proud of you.
Amazing. Some beautiful colours now, and you said that you got it from photographing balloons and chiffon, having them in chiffon, and then
cut layering it up. Edited it a little bit and just layered it down until it got like the spine effect on the middle.
It's like moth, spine, signs of lambs.
Quite creepy, but it's quite nice at the same time.
Oh, it's beautiful. Thank you very much for showing it to
us. That's okay.
And good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Thank you. So many different parts of the textile degree that you can now focus on. One of them is embroidery, and there's lots of people working around this room now on lots of almost domestic machines and also machines that are much more sort of dedicated to computer design as well, like this one just here. So joined now by Poonab, who's in the final year of your degree now, aren't you, for textiles. Why did you choose textiles?
Well, I kind of wasn't really sure what I wanted to do, and the course here offers you like embroidery, print, CT, and you get to do weaving and knitting. And like some of the other courses like around the UK, they only do specialise in weave or knit, they don't do both.
Right, so it gave you a bit more of a broader...
Yeah, definitely. Thank so I just felt that Birmingham was the right place to come.
And, yeah. What's CT, people
don't know? CT is constructed textiles, and you get two pathways, which is knitted textiles and woven textiles. So you get to, in the first, I think you have like 2 weeks to do a knit pathway and 2 weeks to do a woven pathway, and then you kind of decide what you want to specialise in for your second year.
Now, I don't think I did any textiles during art at school at all. I mean, screen printing, that was it. I mean, is there an element of that in this as well?
Yeah, you do that in print, you do that in first year, you do screen printing, and then if you choose to specialise in that, then you do like digital printing, and you can still use screen printing.
Yeah, did you do any sort of textiles before this course? Did you know that you wanted to do it?
Do you know what, before I actually even applied for textiles, I was going to do drama, so yeah, kind of changed my idea, but I did like GCSE textiles, art and drama, and then I did A-level art, drama and textiles, so it was kind of... one way or the other.
Yeah, totally. We've just walked around all the different rooms. It's huge, isn't it? The textile department. The different rooms and all the different equipment. It's, it looks really well set up.
Yeah, you've got a lot of space and you can kind of experiment as long as you, you know, negotiate with the technicians. Or even though I'm specialising in woven textiles, if I wanted to go down and print, I can go down and print, because you kind of get that first sort of basic knowledge in your first year, and then, you know, you've got friends in print and you just say, oh, can you help me do this, and they just help you do it.
Yeah, totally. And I was talking to the course leader as well and saying that in the third year you can decide to do a more theoretical part of it, where you can go into sort of textile management and things like that as well.
It's like visual merchandising, like the more sort of the retail side of it, but I wanted to stick to designing and stuff because it's a lot.
Yeah, it's a nice, it's just a nice chilled atmosphere here, isn't
it? Yeah, it's wicked.
People listening to the radio since their iPods, just creating.
Yeah, we're here from like 10 to 7 every day.
Really?
Yeah.
It seems like a nice kind of bunch of people.
Yeah, everyone kind of gets on, and if you're stuck, I think somebody helps you, so it's really good.
Wicked. Does everyone expect you to make their Christmas presents?
Yeah, or they're like, oh, can you do this for me?
Yeah,
it's like, no, I've got to do my final project.
Yeah, so. Is that right?
Yeah.
Cool, thank you very much. So you're going to show something now, aren't you, that you're working on, so look at that now. Yeah. We're off. So what are these called? These don't look like boats to me.
Yeah, these are called shuttles. Basically, you wind off the colour that you need, and you wind it off on like a newspaper, and then, just the easiest way to put it through.
How do you know what colour you need?
The way I work is I do like windings and stuff, and then basically get like some card and you wind certain colours around it depending on the proportion of colour that you want to do for your design.
Okay.
And then when you're putting the pattern into the computer, it kind of shows you what your fabric will look like, and you can get like a 3D view of it and the front and the back. Play around with it on that before you start actually putting your sort of correct fabric.
Yeah, because the back, like the front and backs, look quite different, don't they? It's like the big sort of pashminas you get.
Yeah,
that people would see.
But you can kind of design it in your own way, whether you want it to look the same, you want it to look different. So it all depends on what you do on the computer before you start weaving it. So it's kind of like that is as much important as it is to actually weave it, because without the computer, you can't weave on it.
Imagine how they did it without computers. Can you imagine how long that would take?
Yeah, even with the other ones that we're doing at the moment, I've set up a hand loom, which is like the old sort of style of actually weaving, and that just takes a lot longer than doing it like this.
So this is the chair that Rebecca was telling us about, the award that she won from studying textile here at Bayard. It's absolutely beautiful. So nice. If you want to have a look online, you can do it. It's ecu.ac.uk. Just click on courses, you'll find textile design there. We found the calf, so I'm going to go and have some chips. Okay.